number 25, Howard. Batting 6, number 10, McKinney. Batting 7, number 13, Mike.
I don't know. She was also all of them, man.
And now for your Lady Tigers starting lineup, leading us off at first at bat, number 12, playing shortstop, Riley Eister. Batting second, number 9, playing third base, Avery Wolf. Batting third, number 8, behind the plate, Allie Callahan. Batting cleanup on the mound, number 11, Jana Shaw. Batting fifth, number 2, the DP for tonight, Julia Shaw. Batting sixth, number 4, at first, Katie White. Batting seventh, number 7, in center field, Avery Taylor. Batting 8, number 1 in left field, Allie Agner. Batting 9th, number 5 in right field, Paige Entry. And your flex player, number 6, playing second base, Jayla Sykes. Overall, please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
At home against the Tupelo Lady Waves. And we are up for the leadoff batter for Tupelo. Quinn in the number one hole spot. Jana Shaw in the circle. First pitch fouled off by Quinn. Go through the Tiger defense in batting order. It's going to be Eister, shortstop, Wolf at third, Callahan behind the plate, Jana in the circle. Katie White playing first. Avery Taylor holding down center field. Allie Agner back with us in left field tonight. And Caitlin Gentry playing right field with the flex. Sites holding down second base. Second pitch from Shaw was a ball down low. And Quinn's going to swing at that outside pitch for strike two. Count now 1-2. On deck for Tupelo is Barry. Janet with two strikes on her, giving her outside pitch. She doesn't chase it. Takes the count 2-2. Gordon Shaw here tonight, sporting the T-shirt in the cold weather. Swing and a miss. Shaw's going to get her first strikeout of the game as Quinn will swing at the off-speed pitch. Going to bring up Barry with Morris on deck for the Tupelo Wave. First pitch from Shaw is going to be a strike called as Barry will look at that first pitch. Here's the 101 pitch from Shaw. Fouls it out of play over behind the concession stand. It's going to be on somebody's car in the parking lot. No balls, two strikes. Tupelo, one out on the board already. Brisk, cool afternoon in Hernando. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Not chasing the outside pitch. She leaves it alone. Ball one. Nice two-strike pitch from Shaw. Batter way up in the box. That's going to be a ball in the dirt by Shaw. 2-2 now is the count. Callahan going to get a clean one. Tigers probably having to do a lot of work to get the field ready for play today. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Another wild pitch from Shaw. It's going to take it to the full count.
All right, bro, get at it, baby.
Putting the ball in play, fouling it off right outside the right field fence. Staying alive at 3-2, and the wind's picking up. Ground ball, foul, down third baseline, just foul. Tigers giving chase. The two-hole hitter for Tupelo is battling here to try and make something happen. Katie White over at first base today. Here comes the 3-2 from Jana. Popped up, out to right field. Gentry with the catch. It's going to be the second out. Sun in her eyes, making it look easy. Brings up the three-hole hitter for Tupelo, Morris to the plate. I may say this name wrong. Stangold on deck. First pitch. Woo! Oh, I don't know what was wrong with that, but it was. Ball one. Strike one. Fouled out of play. Whew. Made a fire out here. One ball, two strikes, two outs on the board for Tupelo. Jana trying to close it out. Out to right field again. Gentry with the third out, making it look easy again with the sun in her face. That's going to be 1-2-3 for Tupelo. Eister, Wolf, Callahan, due up.
Not the
57. Wow. Eister, bottom of the first. Going to get the Tigers lead it off. First pitch going to miss up high. We call a strike to Eister. Count now 1-1. That's going to get above the pit, the catcher. That's going to be two balls, one strike. Now to Eister. Go through the Tupelo defense here in just a moment. Next pitch is going to be down low outside. It's going to be take the count now to 3-1 to the Tiger leadoff. Avery Wolf is on deck. That's going to be low in the dirt. So that's going to be a walk for Eister. And that'll bring up Wolf to the plate. Callahan on deck. It's going to be down low. Catcher blocking it up. Eicher's going to take second base. Now, Wolf be looking for a pitch to put in play and score Eicher. It's going to be an inside pitch. Catcher letting it get away from her. Now, Eicher's going to cruise over to third base. Takes the count to Wolf, 2-0. Inside, down low. Catcher blocking it up. No runner. Thirty-0's to count. No outs on the board for the Tigers. Strike one. Umpire loudly calling out the count. Wolf putting the ball in play, fouling it off. 3-2 now. She finds herself with a full count.
Babysit.
A little low inside. It's going to walk Wolf. That's going to be two straight base on balls. Brings Callahan up to the deck. Shaw. Callahan up to the plate. Shaw on deck. Jana Shaw. First pitch, Callahan going to be a strike. Wolf's going to cruise over to second. Tupelo getting the pitch count. Here comes the 0-1 pitch to Callahan. Low, catcher blocking it, rolling toward Eister, straight at her on third, unable for her to make a run in the home on that play. She would have been out very easily on that. As the ball rode right down third baseline. 1-1 is the count now to Callahan. Low and outside, the ball gets right behind the catcher. Umpire's going to kick it around a little bit. Pitcher comes in, actually picks the ball up, takes it back to the circle. Two one now is the count to Callahan. Knight on first base trying to shade her eyes. That sun's right in it. Callahan's going to swing on outside pitch and miss it, taking it to 2-2 now. Callahan getting a piece of it right under it, fouling it off, staying alive, still with the 2-2 count. Double deuces. 3-2 now it's count. That's going to miss up high in the zone to Callahan. Dropped in there kind of close. I was skeptical to see what the umpire was going to call that. It's now the full count. Callahan needs to be looking to hit. And Callahan's going to strike out on an inside pitch up inside the zone. And that's going to be a K on the books. Brings up Jana Shaw to the plate. Shaw's going to swing at the first pitch. Going to go to the shortstop, and they're going to make the throw over to first. It's not going to be in time. Throw across the diamond to third, and they're going to tag Avery Wolf out at third base. That's going to be two outs on the board for Tupelo. Safe. Higginbotham's going to go in and run for the pitcher today, Jana. Meister's going to score on that last sequence of events. Shaw. First pitch, strike. Higginbotham's going to cruise over to second. It's going to stay up high, just missing outside part of his own, taking the count to 1-1. Inside, ball two. That's going to be, I don't know where it went, right up the middle for Julia Shaw. Higginbotham's going to come on in and score in running for the other Shaw and give Julia a single RBI. Puts the Tigers up two runs.
Located.
Avery Taylor on deck. Katie White at the plate. It's going to go, it's going to roll behind Katie White. Catcher blocking it up, keeping it out in front of her. Going to put Julia over on second base now. Count 1-0. Way up and outside, and Julia's going to cruise over to third. Going to be a called strike to Katie White. Missing inside. It's going to take it to 3-1. Katie White's going to foul it off down third baseline, taking her to a full count. Three, low inside. And Julia didn't score on the pass ball by the catcher. And Katie White's going to ease down to third base. The first base on the walk. Avery Taylor to the plate. Agner on deck. Call pitch outside part of the plate. Strike one to Avery Taylor. Just missing the feet of Avery Taylor. It's going to be ball one. Comes to 1-1, up high, ball two. Low catcher blocking it up. It's going to be 3-1 now. That's going to be a walk for Avery Taylor. Allie Agner to the plate. She's been out for a little bit. She's back. The young Gentry on deck. Ball low outside. Bases loaded for Allie Agner. With two outs on the board. Just missing low, ball two. Low outside, ball three. Three O's to count. She puts one in there on the 3-0 count for strike one. What are you looking for, your kid? Comes to 3-1 to Agner. Low, it's going to be a walk. And that's going to walk in a run. It's going to bring Gentry back to the plate or up to the plate here for her first at bat this afternoon. Gentry into the outfield, and it's going to be, that was a catch. It's going to be the third out. Gentry will fly up a nice, that's an outstanding catch by the left fielder for Tupelo. That's going to be the third out, and we go into the top of the second. Tigers up 3-0. Fun fact for everyone, third base coach for Tupelo, former Lady Tiger softball coach here in Hernando many, many years ago. It's going to bring up Stangold to the plate. First pitch will be ball one from Shaw. Powell on deck. Called strike from Shaw. Comes to 1-1. Holds up, ball two. That's going to hit the batter. And Shaw will pull her on base with a hit by pitch. Howell to the plate. McKinney comes out on deck. And Tupelo has a base runner. She shows the bunt. Strike one. Showing the bunt, pulling back, swinging. Strike two. Outside, missing ball one from Shaw. Runner thinking about it. She stays at first. Fouling it over toward her dugout. Next pitch by Howell, she's going to foul it off. Still sitting on two strikes. Fouled off toward their dugout again. Lee, I wish the wind quit blowing. One, two, still to count. Tupelo would run on first after getting hit by the pitch. Swinging. And Blue said she was out before she even left running down the third base. Callahan caught the ball down low. It was never in the dirt. And that's going to be one out on the board for Tupelo, as that'll go down as a strikeout for Howell. Brings up McKinney, the senior knight on deck. Strike in the heart up a little high. Blue says it's gonna be strike one. Strike two. Up and outside, Callahan throwing down the first, trying to pick a runner off. She gets back in time. Fouls it straight up. It's going to be back here, out of play. Almost into the head of one of the parents. Gordon Shaw not even attempting to try to make a play on that ball. Almost letting it hit the head of a lady over there. Man. One ball, two strikes, one out on the board for Tupelo. Stangold still on first after getting hit by the pitch. As she was the leadoff batter, top of the second. Low, Callahan blocks it up. Shaw now taking the count to 2-2. Fouling it off into the parking lot. Lee's going to ring her up looking. Back-to-back strikeouts for Shaw brings up Knight to the plate. The catcher comes out on deck. Gillen. Low, ball one. Thinks about swinging, checks up, smart decision, ball two. First strike. Pop it up out of play. It's going to take her to the 2-2 count with two outs on the board. Low, Callahan snagging it up. Shaw taking it to a full count. That's going to be a walk. Shaw will lose the battle. Knight wins. Tupelo now with two runners on base. Two outs on the board to catch a Gillen at the plate. First pitch, strike one looking. Down low. One wants the count. Shaw missing outside. Two wants the count. Gillen puts the swing on it, missing. And that's going to be a fair ball on the line out right field. And that's going to put up two runs for Tupelo. One run. Knight's going to hold up at third. And the hit by pitch comes back and does you know what every time as she will score a run. Going to bring up it's Cooper, I believe it's Cooper Wood to the plate for Tupelo. Quinn, the leadoff batter, should be on deck. Shows the bunt, gets a little tip of it, goes straight down to the plate back behind everybody's legs to the backstop, strike one. I would, Pendleton. Who wants to count? Swinging, strike two. This game originally on the schedule for yesterday. Swinging, strike three. And Shaw will get the Tigers out of trouble as Tupelo was threatening to put another run on the board. We go to the bottom of the second, Tigers 3-1. Umpire calling time. calling the trainer over to the onto the field. We kind of injury with one of the Tupelo players. Sort of left fielder, I believe. We'll be right back. We're back. Heister leading us off.
Bottom of the second.
Heister's going to lay down the bunt. She's going to field it in foul territory, strike one. New pitcher in the circle for Tupelo. Left-handed pitcher. Comes 0-1 to Eister. Low. Ball getting past the catcher. No runners on. No harm done. One one to Eister. Goes for the bunt. Pulls it back. Falls in the zone, strike two. Up high in the zone, ball two. Isher's going to send it out to left field, making the catch. Isher's going to fly out. Is the left fielder for Tupelo. It's a 7 unassisted out, brings up Wolf to the plate. Eister walked her last at bat. She'll fly out this time. Wolf walked her last at bat. Callahan's on deck. Wolf's going to hit a ground ball through the hole of second base, and that's going to give Tigers a base runner. For Callahan at the plate, Jana Shaw coming out on deck. Callahan struck out her last at bat. So put a single down for Wolf. Lefty on lefty matchup here. Low outside, ball one to Callahan. I don't know why I said this pitcher was a left-handed pitcher. She's obviously a right-handed pitcher. Here comes the 1-0 to Callahan, low in the dirt. Ball's going to get behind the catcher. She comes up with it, and Wolf's going to cruise over to second base. Callahan now with a runner in scoring position. Two balls and no strikes. Up high in the eyes of Callahan, she's now looking at the 30 count. Nowhere to put it here, but somewhere in the zone. Stays high, missing. It's going to be a walk for Callahan. Shaw's going to take first pitch out into left field. It's going to get past the left fielder, and that's going to score Wolf. Callahan's going to hold up at third base. So Jana will start out with a stand-up double as she attacks that first pitch. Julia at the plate singled her last at bat, as did Jana. That's going to bring Katie White out on deck. And that is out of here. Foul ball. Over the fence, but foul. Pitch is going to drop that pitch, and that's going to roll in. Missing the pile. It's going to take the count to 2-1. What? 3-1 now. Why not use it, man? Shaw's going to take the 3-1 count pitch and pop it up to middle infield, right in the edge of the outfield, and they're going to drop it, and that's going to score Callahan. And Julius Shaw is going to be sitting on first now with the runner in for Jana, still on second base, going to be Olivia Higginbotham. Going to go down as a ROE on Julia as she center field is going to put a glove on that ball. Brings up Katie White to the plate. Callahan scored after walking. Katie White walked her last at bat. Going to bring Avery Taylor out on deck. One ball, no strikes to White. Comes the pitch. That was right down the pipe. White's going to swing under it, foul it off back into the net. It's good over here by me. Once across the board. White's going to pop it up. Knight camping out underneath it. Out number two. As Knight's going to make a catch. Katie White fly out. Avery Taylor coming to the plate. Agner on deck. They both walked their last at bat. Going to come in and miss high. That's going to roll in right in front of the feet of Avery Taylor. Runners will advance. Two balls, no strikes. Inside ball three. Ah, 3-1 now, Scott. Yanking it foul. Taking it to the full count. That's going to be a walk. And the catcher's going to let the ball get past her, and that's going to allow Higginbotham to come in and score on the passed ball, which was the run for Jana Shaw. Julia Shaw now on third, brings up Allie Agner to the plate. Gentry on deck. Outside, catcher's going to let the ball get away from her. And Julia's going to come in and score. It's now 7-1 ball game. Avery Taylor's going to be on third. Here we go. do what I do. Two balls, no strikes. Missing up and outside. Going to take it to the 30 count to Ali Agner. Sophomore left fielder. Maybe Taylor on third. Outside. Base on balls. Brings Gentry to the plate. The nine-hole hitter for Hernando. Leister comes back out on deck. Gentry flew out to left field, her last at bat. She's going to lay down a beautiful bunt. They're going to make the throw over to first. And they're going to call out the fast runner, Gentry, out at first. Not letting the Tigers get that score in. And that's going to take us to the top of the third. It's 7-1 ball game. Quinn leadoff for Tupelo coming to the plate for Tupelo in the top of the third. Over to Wolf. Wolf the first, out number one. Brings Barry to the plate, flew out to the right fielder, her last at bat. Young seventh grader. Taking the first pitch, strike one. Barry is a Bombers player in the travel ball world. In her 2027 class, she is 77th in the nation for her class ranking. She's going to hit a hard ground ball to Eister. Eister over the first, out number two. But Katie White bumbled it just a little bit, but she picks it back up, maintains control of the ball to get the out on Barry. Barry hit to a 6-3 out, brings up Morris to the plate. Flew out to the right fielder, her last at bat. Coach for Tupelo coming out, questioning the call there briefly. And here we go. Strike one, looking to Morris. Oh! Over in foul territory to the first base side. Taking it to the 0-2 count. Katie White giving quick chase to it. You might want to scoot back with her. No balls, two strikes, two outs on the board. Up and outside, ball one. Nice two-strike pitch from Shaw. I better get my foot down. One ball, two strikes. Fouled out of play. Back of the lineup coming up for the Tigers when we come back up in the bottom of the third. It's going to be Iser, Wolf, and Callahan. Over to White. White to first out. It's going to be the third out. Here we come up with Iser, Wolf, and Callahan. Iser looking to get a hit of the game. She has a walk and a fly out. A lot of Tigers looking to get a hit for the game. Here we go. Tupelo still with the same pitcher in the circle. Rest of the defense remains the same. She's going to lay down a beautiful bunt, and they're going to throw over to first, but it's nowhere in time for the Speedy Gonzalez Iser, as she's going to start us out with a single. Brings up Wolf, who is 0 for 1. I'm sorry, she is 1 for 1 on the day with a walk and a single. The Wolf 1 for 1. Callahan comes out on deck, who is 0 for 1 with a strikeout and a walk. There goes Iser the second, and they're going to throw. It's going to be really wide. And they're going to call Iser out for leaving the bag early. That's unfortunate. It's going to be inside. It's going to be 0-1 now to Wolf with no runners on, one out on the board. Wolf's going to be back up the middle. It's going to land in the grass. She didn't hit it hard, but she hit it as hard as she needed to. Like it came in on her. She's going to push it out there into the edge of the grass. Brings up Callahan to the plate. That's going to be Wolf's back-to-back singles. Callahan looking to get a hit in the game. She walked her last at bat. Jana is going to come out on deck. She was 2-for-2 on the day. First pitch, Callahan is going to be up above her head. Catcher jumping up with a great snag there for Tupelo. Keeping Wolf on first. Watch out now. You had it up in there. The blanket was up in there. Callahan swinging for the fences. Going to be strike one. Callahan now with a 1-1 count, one out on the board. Up and outside, 2-1 now's count. Outside, ball three. Callahan swinging under. She's going to foul it off, and she now faces a full count. Got to be patient. Got to wait. Wolf on first. Callahan is going to put a second K up for today. Wolf on first, Shaw at the plate. That ball's deep. That's going to be caught by the center fielder out number three. 1-1 now is the count to Morris. Stangold on deck, then do what would be Howe for Tupelo. It's going to be fouled over to Katie White at first base. Two strikes now. Shaw's going to put a strike out on the board. One to count. Tupelo with one out on the board. Now that went off into the light pole. Two strikes. Fouled off onto the plate. Umpire quickly calling in a foul ball. Fly out there in the right field. Gentry coming in. It's going to get past her. She's going to dive down for it. And that's going to give Tupelo a runner on second base. It's going to bring up Howell to the plate. McKinney on deck. Only one out on the board for Tupelo. They got a runner on second. It's going to show the bunt. It's going to go to Wolf. Wolf over to first. They're going to get the out. Run's going to move on around the third base. So Howell will come up and do her job with the sack bunt. Brings up McKinney to the plate. Knight's on the, I've gotten off somewhere. That was McKinney. It's going to be Knight at the plate. Outside ball one. Knight with two outs on the board now with a run on third. She has a good RBI opportunity here for the Tupelo. Get another run on the board. She walked her last at bat. She fouls that one back here out of play. 1-1 now. Mm-hmm. Knight's going to swing, taking it to 1-2 count. Outside, ball two. Ball three. Knight now finds himself back with a full count. Knight's going to strike out, and that's going to end. We go down to the bottom of the fourth. Due up is going to be Shaw White Taylor. Tigers are up. Julia Shaw at the plate. She's going to pop it up. It's going to stay in the infield. Pitcher out number one. As Shaw will fly out to the one hole. Katie White at the plate. Avery Taylor on deck. White looking for her first hit. She has a walk and a fly out. She's going to pop that up, and that's going to stay in play. Center fielder making the catch. Out number two. Avery Taylor, back-to-back walks today. Agner comes out on deck. First ball, the Taylor's low in the dirt. Ball strike one. Ball two. Ball three. Ball strike, Avery Taylor takes it to the full count. And he popped up, first baseman's coming over, Knight with the catch. And the Tigers have put a 1-2-3 up and out on the board.
Tupelo comes out. That's going to be a pop fly ball out to Gentry in right field. It's going to be out number three. Tupelo comes up with two ground outs and a fly out, and we go into the bottom of the fifth. Tigers up by six in a 7-1 game. Agner's going to come up, and she will take one out to left field, out number one, as she flies out to the seven hole, brings up Gentry to the plate. Gentry's at the plate with the 1-1 count after Agner's going to fly out to left field. Gentry, who is 0-for-2 on the day with a fly out and a ground out. Now at the plate with a 2-1 count. Gentry looks at that 2-1 pitch for a strike. Feister on deck. Down in the hole, Gentry with a base hit.
Eichler with a walk, a fly out, and a single. Gentry's going to take second. She's going to be safe. One old Eichler, runner on second. Ball two. Three oh to Eichler. Be a base on balls for Eichler. Wolf to the plate. Higginbotham on deck. Wolf with a walk and two singles today. First pitch is going to be a strike. They're going to throw down the third for Gentry and Eichler, both going to steal a bag. Wolf just getting under. It's going to foul it off as she waits on the off-speed pitch from Tupelo. Makes it 0-2 now. Wolf with a hard ground ball. It's going to be foul. Three two now to Wolf. Should be 3-2. Two twos to count. Three two now. Wolf's going to take that out the left field. It's going to be into the glove of the left fielder. And Gentry's going to tag. So will Eichler. And that's going to be a sack fly for Wolf. It's now 8-1. Higginbotham up to the plate. In for Callahan.